How to fix Windows update stuck at 0%, 82%, 87%, 92%, or 100%. So if your Windows update stuck at these percentages, then what you need to do is you need to go for the search icon and then you need to search for troubleshoot. So go for the search tab and then search for troubleshoot. And here you will have troubleshoot settings, right? Go for the troubleshoot settings, and under your troubleshoot, now you need to simply go for other troubleshooters. And here you may have an option of Windows update, right? So if you have the Windows update, you need to simply click on the run, which is on the right side. And now there's Windows 11 troubleshooter, and you will find the Windows update, and you just need to click on run. And now this Windows 11 troubleshooter is really a very powerful, effective tool, which you can do it at the first place. Now, for most of them, it will work here, and it might possibly doesn't take the other step. So it will take some time, and once it will start diagnosing, or once it's done, you just need to restart the computer and see if you are able to update your Windows 11 or not. And if you still have issues, we will move to the next step. Now for that, either you can press the Windows or R key, or you can simply go for the Windows, right click on that, and then you can go for run. And you will have the run tab, right? So under this tab, you need to search for services.msc. And then click on OK, and here you will have all of the services. Now the services window will open, and here we are looking for the Windows update service. So select any one of the service and then type W, and here you will have all of the services with which starts with W, right? Now look for the Windows update. So I have the Windows update right here. You need to simply right click on that, and then you need to go for properties. Once you're here on the properties, you will have this kind of interface where under the startup type, you need to choose automatic option. So make sure that you have the automatic option, and then you need to click on apply and okay. Once you've done that, now you need to click on the restart. So you just need to refresh or restart the whole Windows update service. And once this is done, you need to restart your computer and see if you are able to update your Windows or not. And if you're still having the issues, then the third and the very powerful step is you just need to search in the command prompt. Just remove this, and then you can go for the Windows, right click on that, and here you may have the command prompt. But if you don't have that, you need to simply go for the search and search for command prompt. So once you've searched for command prompt, now make sure that you don't click on open. Just click on run as administrator and then click on yes. And here you will have this kind of interface where you need to enter code. Here you need to enter net space stop and then again space and W U A U S E R V. So you need to enter W U A U S E R V. Once you enter that, you need to hit the enter button. Once you hit the enter button, now the Windows update is going to be stopped. And once this is stopped, click on the File Explorer and then go for this PC and go for the local disk or C disk. And under this, you will have Windows option. Right click on the Windows, and here you will have all of the applications or all of the folders regarding to your Windows. And here you need to search for software distribution. Click on the software distribution, and under your software distribution, your Windows will get downloaded and gets installed to the operating system right here. And you need to simply create a new folder on your desktop, and then you need to transfer your files or anything that you have on your laptop or your desktop. Once you've done that, now you need to again come for the command prompt, and under here, you need to enter net space start space W U A U S E R V. So previously we've stopped the Windows update. Now we'll start the Windows update. So simply enter the same command and hit the enter, and it will say that your Windows update service has been successfully started. And now you just need to restart your computer and try to update your Windows. Once you've done that, now your problem will be fixed. And that's it. That's how you can fix the Windows 11 update stuck. And if you have any questions, feel free to comment below. Thanks for watching.